A legal advisor of Edo State Minister of Justice Kenneth Ugyagbe has been reportedly arrested by Department of Security Services DSS over allegation of bribery in the case of alleged extrajudicial killing of Benson Obode by some policemen. The policemen allegedly involved in the act are Adedeji Adeleke, Oniyo Musa, Abana John, and Henry Oshobowole. Benson Obode was accused of purchasing a stolen car, an arch color unregistered 306 Peugeot car said to have been given to him by a friend to sell when he was arrested before he was gruesomely killed under a controversial circumstance. Kenneth Ugyagbe's arrest was in response to a petition written by barrister Abraham Viawe in protest against the accused person's action of allegedly collecting 1 million naira from the families of the policemen accused in the murder case of Benson Obode. It was gathered that Mr. Kenneth Ugyagbe has already been queried and suspended from the Ministry of Justice while investigation is being carried out.
We got wind of very ungodly happenings by ministers in the Temple of Justice. A lawyer from the Ministry of Justice went as far as to the prisons where the accused persons are, requesting for the sum of 1 million naira to approach the judge to compromise him for the grant of their bail and to destroy the case. We got wind of that information, and immediately we swung into action just to say that that money was paid to him into his account in installment.
Abraham Viawe's petition indicated that the policemen, in the inability to secure a bail application after the bribery, infuriated the policemen's relatives.
We got hold of that very vital information, and we did not rest on our asses. We had filed a petition to the Ministry of Justice. We have called the attention of the Permanent Secretary. The lawyer has since been queried and suspended. The attention of the SSS, the DSS, have also been called to it. A minister in the Temple of Justice cannot be called to pervert justice. The blood of Benson Obode is crying for justice, and everybody, no matter how highly placed in the conspiratorial theory, in the conspiracy theory, to subvert the course of justice, must meet his Waterloo.
The development, according to Abraham Viawe, caused their relatives to demand for their money, which he allegedly promised to be paid in installments. Apart from the DSS, Barrister Viawe also petitioned offices of the Commissioner of Justice and Attorney General of the State, Barrister Henry Dagmon, and the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry, Wole Iyamu. Viawe asked that the accused person should be thoroughly investigated for allegedly perverting justice.
Mr. Kenneth Ugyagbe, I am aware that he has been invited by the DSS, and investigations are ongoing. Let me seize the opportunity to encourage the Department of State Security, who have over time done what Napoleon could not do. As the drum of anti-corruption is being beaten all over the country where judges have been arrested, it is not in doubt that lawyers of this magnitude are those who approach them for compromise and give bad names to the judiciary. He must be used as a sacrificial lamb for all those who have been indulging in such kind of art over the years. The time is now to bring injustice to its name.
Meanwhile, the counsel to the accused person, Otumba Goke Olakun, denied that his client was involved in the allegation leveled against him.
That is unfounded. That is wild goose. It cannot be substantiated. Before I came into the matter, early this year, the accused person are entitled to bail. They sought bail. The bail was not forthcoming. And they briefed a counsel whom they knew has a connections in the Benin there, that he can get them a lawyer to assist them to get bail. That was the basis of contacting the person. Nobody gave money to anybody for bribe. Nobody. And I'm sure whosoever was the author of your information must have goofed. There was no basis. In fact, the SS called me while I was at the Court of Appeal, Port Harcourt, yesterday. And I promised by the grace of God, I will see them.
This is coming when some judges across the Federation are being accused of corruption. Nosa Hare Wadia, STV News.